Well, howdy, 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 folks. I am glad to be here. Hope you are, too. And you can't see me yet, but you're fixing to. Just bear with me a second, and we'll get started. I want to share something. I got several questions. She even numbered them and sent them by email about lemonade vending, and I want to cover those real quick and help you out. The first one being how to keep your ice, you know, because ice melts, and typically you're vending when it's hot. And so it makes sense that, you know, a rock and a hard place type deal. So anyway, I am, I'm checking. Okay, I am, let me get my camera back over here. I have this, check that out. Man, hopefully you can see this. All right. Matthew Orthet here, howdy howdy, from Groveland, California. That's freaking awesome. Thanks for being here. So the question was, I know some people get mad at me because I smoke during these sometimes, but I'm a smoker, so there you have it. So anyway, what we're going to cover is several questions about lemonade vending, and maybe you've had these questions. Then I'm going to give you a link to a free course that I wrote, and there's nothing to buy here. It's just... great information, and let me tell you why. There's a lot of people, and I'm not going to read you the whole email, but they were going to start a kettle corn business, and they decided it was going to be a lot easier and less expensive to start lemonade, because lemonade you can start quick and easy, and we're going to talk about how to do that through these questions and answers real quick for you, so hopefully that'll help. Hey, Max, and look at there, Jeff Mack in the house. That's my bud from out in Texas. All right, so... Here's the deal. Let me turn this down. That looks freaking high as a kite on my volume. Okay, so hopefully you can still hear me okay. I wish I had a Jeff Mack that lived here and he could set up all my audio equipment, because I have had a challenge. Jeff, I got that Rodecaster Pro, and man, am I having trouble getting the audio to work right. And I have Heil PR40 whatever mics, and two of those, you know, but they work great with my other equipment, but I wanted to use this equipment because it's smaller. Bottom line is, it's just one of those deals. Howdy, Steve. Stever in the house. Glad to see you, brother. All right, so here's the deal. Man, y'all got some great stuff popping up. Love it. All right, so let me get started real quick, because otherwise people get mad and they go, Ben, you just ramble on and waste my time. And I probably do. So I apologize. It's the hillbilly in me. So here we go. First question is, my questions are, and then she numbered them. How do I keep ice from melting for 4 to 5 hours? Do you have a specific cooler that you recommend, or any cooler will work? Well, let me tell you this. Yeti coolers are awesome, but you have to hawk a kidney to be able to buy them. So I would recommend regular coolers, an Igloo cooler, a Coleman cooler rated for 5 days. I have done this, and I've even done it at events where they are longer than 4 to 5 hours. Now, there's some tricks to this, okay? There's some secrets. Never open your cooler unless you have to, and then get in it and get out quick, okay? So what I would do is I'd lay the bags in the cooler, and then I'd take one out as needed, shut it, and dump that into a cooler bucket or a... You've seen those thermos coolers on the back of utility trucks with no lid on it. I'll take the lid off, dump my ice in there, and that way I can scoop out with an ice scoop right into my glasses. So that's one easy way to do it. There's other ways to do it, but that's an easy way to do it. Now, if you're doing a big event, it can get a little tricky because you got to have tons of ice. So... a lot of times, though, at big events, there's multiple vendors, and those vendors are all needing stuff. And usually the broadline distributor, U.S. Foods, Cisco, one of those food companies has a truck on site. And you can say, hey, I need ice. And they'll keep ice on the truck for you. Get it as you need it. Keep it in a cooler. That way, they're keeping it frozen for you. Now, the other way is I did a big event 2 years in a row, and I went, and the first year I tried to do it all myself with coolers, a lot of coolers. Okay, and I had ice melt, or I had to bust the ice because it'd start melting and get, I guess it got cold again or whatever, but you know, ice sticks together, clumps, and then it was a pain, so I'm trying to bust it. It just was a headache. The next time, I called the ice company and I said, Can you just bring me a cooler and I'll plug it in? Because I had power. So we plugged it in. They brought the cooler, filled it for ice, only charged me for the ice I used. They ended up having to come back at the end of the day to refill it because I didn't even have enough to make it through till the evening. So it is a great way to do this, is to buy your ice that way. But if you're just doing small little gigs and lemonade stands, coolers work great, okay? Just limit your flow into it. Don't dump all your ice in the cooler and think you're going to just leave the lid open and scoop out of it on a 104 degree day. So it just you're going to end up with more water than ice. Which water's great for making more ice, but if you ain't got an ice maker there, you're in trouble. So that's the first one. How much ice, bottled water, and sugar do I need to buy for each event? Well, there's a loaded question, okay? I just answered, she had this as a second part of this question, where do I purchase in bulk? You purchase ice in bulk through the ice distributor, okay, the local ice guy. You probably have two or three of them. And you can find those real quick. Go by any gas station or any ice, you know, in the grocery store. We've got a nice big old ice container thing where you can get bags of ice. It has the company name on there. So you just buy the ice from, you call them and say, listen, I need ice. And you can go by their shop and pick it up if you're buying smaller quantities, but it's cheaper than the grocery store. So the other thing is how much ice and bottled water and sugar do I need to bring? Well, that's the loaded question part because there's no way to really know how much to bring, right? I mean, you can guesstimate, and we have in the Vendors United, we got some like some crazy math, and you know, we take pi, and then we take the hypotenuse of a basketball, and we figure out, I'm just kidding, but we figure out close based on the attendance, past attendance, you know, the historical attendance, that would have sounded better. And then we take in the account, the number of vendors, the number of people expected, what's the weather forecast look like. So you can take in a lot of stuff, or you can just play it safe. I like safe. I'd rather run out than have extra or have overbought for my little event. And this goes for any kind of food vending. If you overbuy, it's a pain in the neck unless you have a place to store it. Well, you don't want to end up with a bunch of lemons. I have a friend who went to a gig out of state last year. It was bad weather, bad event. And he ended up with thousands of lemons more than he needed. What do you do with all that? Well, he ended up squeezing it and freezing the juice. But now you've lost that feel of doing it in front of the customer. So, well, here's the rule of thumb that's the safest. Buy as much as you can afford and store. If you're going to buy tons, buy as much as you can store and save, or know that you have other gigs planned right afterwards so that you can use it, but never more than what would cause you financial problems, financial difficulty. Because I've been to events where I could have made 20,000, no joke. But I sold out way before it was time for the event to be over because I played it safe. I'd rather play it safe because I can tell you horror stories of vendors going to events and losing their butts, some of them going out of business over one event. So never risk more than you can afford to risk. If it all got destroyed, can you afford to walk away and start over tomorrow? That's the thing you have to ask yourself. So, now, next one. I'm guessing with all that syrup, there's going to be fruit flies. How can I run fans all day if you don't have access to electricity? I don't like doing the simple syrup. Some people do. I like Ken Packer's method, and yet it's in my free course. You can see his video and everything. And if you're wondering where the free course is, it's howtostartalemonadebusiness.com or howtostartalemonadestand.com. I got two websites. Both of them are busy. Over 72. One was a duplicate, and so it said 73, but 72. 72 people downloaded that free course today. That gives you an idea. That's a lot of freaking, a lot of information for free you can have. Just go there and download it. I have both things. I walk you through different stories, different ways to do it, different tactics. Now, I don't like doing the simple syrup method. I like simple syrup to sugar water, okay? And it makes it quick. I like to shake it right in front of them, pour the sugar right in, and like Ken Packer does. And the reason is because that eye candy and part of that whole pitch. And that's how some of these vendors are getting $8 a cup, a 32-ounce cup, which holds about 15.5 ounces of freaking lemonade. That's all it holds once you put ice in it. So, and with the lemon halves in it. So you end up with a really, really good profit margin. Okay? We talked about profit margins the other day. So I would do the sugar mix. You actually mix it, put the sugar, water, shake your booty, and then you dump it into their cup that you're preparing for them. So that is the way to go. Now, the next question, this is from, and I hope I don't butcher this name, it's Toba or Thoba, but that's the name. And I'm not even 100% sure it's a she, I just assumed. Maybe I was wrong. Do you have the best lemon smasher? She or he asked me. I have no lemon smasher. So I have the ones I bought, but I tell you in my course where I got them. I got them on freaking Amazon. So, and they work great. I'll tell you which one I bought. And it's not even an affiliate link. You can just go buy it. Okay? So just buy those hand smashers. They're, and anything you want extra. Let's say you want this. Look at this sexy thing right here. I'm going to show you behind me. Okay? Maybe. Okay, I think I messed that up. Where is my... There it is. Here's my fade level. Okay, you see this thing? You could get fancy as heck. Okay? You can have a crazy, crazy stuff going on. But why would you? Look at this one right here. I'm going to take myself off for a minute. I'm going to show you something. Nope, wrong image. Okay, I'm gonna have to try something different. Let's do this. I want to show you this lemonade stand. That's just basic. You don't need anything fancy. You'll make just as much money as the person in that fancy lemonade stand as you will just a basic table and stuff. You look at, Ken Packer's setup, which I share those with you when I interviewed him. Here's one I did, okay? Here's one I went and did. If I can get this picture up here. Dadgummit. Why ain't my picture going up? That's stupid. What's that called? Let's see. Y'all bear with me. Okay. That Jeff Mack I was talking about earlier, that's him right there. I got that picture to come up. Why can't I get my lemonade stand coming up? Okay, you're just going to have to just take my word for it. I had a picture of me vending, but I've got a video of it and everything here on YouTube. So it's not like it doesn't exist. Let me go back to this custom and I'm going to take that back down. Okay, so you can let the business buy it. So why I'm saying that is you don't need all this fancy equipment. A tablecloth over a table or two tables with, and you'll, if you look at Ken Packer's, which I show you his layout, and banners and a canopy tent and hand smashers, because hand smashing is nostalgic. Now, it is cool to have one of them fancy Smisher Smasher things. It is cool, okay? But you ain't got to have it. And there is no sense in spending the money right now when you don't need to. Why need to? Okay? Later, when you got some money in your pocket and you're like, what am I going to do with this money? I don't know what to do with it. Then go get you something fancy. Okay? Or go gamble or, you know, or buy your kids something or grandkids something. Lemonade is literally making, there's some vendors in our group that are making over $100,000 a year in lemonade just during the summer months. $100,000 in lemonade. Okay? So just think about that because it's a great opportunity for you. Now let me go through this real quick because somebody mentioned something in here. Look, Packers Concessions is in the house. Okay? He's in Pennsylvania right now for an event. That's who I was talking about a minute ago, Ken Packer. So let me show you this. Somebody asked something. This was a cool one. I have never heard of this, but I love me some jalapenos, so this has got to be good. How can it not be? How about that jalapeno lemonade? I have no idea how that'd be, but it sounds good. I'd eat it or drink it. I put jalapeno slices in a Bloody Mary, like a gob of them. I make it like a salad inside my Bloody Mary. Let's see. I'm just seeing if I missed anybody. What size cups? What change per cups? 32-ounce cups, standard, okay? What to charge for cups? Most vendors are at 6. Some vendors are at 7. Some are at 8, okay? So it depends on your, I guess, your environment, your the economics of your area. But I don't know of any under 5, any, at all. Not for a 32-ounce. And I wouldn't have multiple sizes. I'd have a extra large, 32-ounce. Here you go. Refills are $1 less. Bring your cup back. Let's see. Express is having fun. Look at this right here. Marco says, Chicago Sausage Express has successfully made funds this year. Thanks, Ben, for the hot dog maker tips. You're absolutely welcome. Thanks for saying so. Look at this. Steve says he'd buy 5 gallons at a time jalapeno lemonade. Now, Steve does lemonade, too. So, Steve and Amy, they do lemonade. They do hot dogs. They do it all, but and kettle corn. So, there's somebody that you could be following. Ken Packer, you need to be following, or knocked in the back of the head. All this information you can grab at howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. Howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. And you'll get you some great stuff. If you want to see some stuff I've written in the blog, learnhotdogs.com/lemon. It's all exciting. How are you making the holes for the straws in the deli cups? I bought lids with holes. Some people don't. I have no idea that answer. It's a great question. Judy asked that question. Let's see. How are you? Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I saw something on Vendors United. A vendor had a hole punch that was part of his press. But I don't know. I didn't see that in action. So I don't know. Let's see. Anybody else? Anybody else? I think that's it. I think I'm going to let you go. I know I promised the next video was going to be about on how to pick a cart. And which cart? And then I got these questions, and I said, you know what? I'm going to cover these, and maybe to inspire some people to get in the lemonade business. The lemonade business will take you far, and it will let you have money that you can buy a food cart or a food trailer or whatever you want. It will bring you to the dance, and it'll dance with you all night. It's just beautiful lemonade. It's a wonderful thing. Vince says he bought a punch. For his deli cup lids. There are handheld hole punches, Robert says. I don't know. See, that's all new to me. The lids I was using had holes. Boop. Drop the straw in there. Except I didn't even drop the straw. I just handled my straw with their cup. So, oh, that's another great one. You know what? Great question, Faith. Great question. Okay, and this you just reminded me of something, because on this email, it wasn't, that came in at 2:19 this morning. I didn't read it then. Okay, I read it about 30 minutes ago. At 4:21 a.m., she writes back and says, have another question. It's about amending the name of the business, blah, blah, blah. But asked about generators and flies. Noah, if you didn't have electricity, how would you run a fan to keep flies away? A generator's the way to go there. You can buy those. I know they're expensive, okay? Try to make it for 2 or 3 outings. Then you'll have the money to buy a little generator, one of them quiet little generators, which I tell you which one I bought, okay? On the free course, you'll have the whole list. And I bought a little portable generator. And it's super quiet. So, and it lasts and lasts and lasts. It just works out great and doesn't hardly pull any electricity. Now, another way is some vendors are using screens. So they have a canopy and they have it screened. And then they have just a section open and one fan running. If you don't have electricity at all, it makes it a little trickier. But it's doable. You can hope for, you know, a slight breeze all day long. But you know how that goes. You either got tornado winds or you got no winds. At least lately. Faces ramble on, let's say. I would definitely try to have a fan going. Even one of those cheap oscillating stand fans. If you need to. If you're in an area where there's a lot of flies and they're attracting flies, keep your stuff wiped down all the time. Wipe down, wipe down, wipe down. If you go to a busy event, have extra help. And that's another benefit of charging more for the lemonade. You're still giving a good value, but you now have money so you can pay good help to be on the spot constantly, wiping down, keeping stuff clean, and it works. If you want to see some of these, I filmed me and Ken doing it. I filmed me and Frankenstein's doing it. So I've got a lot out there for you to see and to kind of get ideas and go, I like that idea. I don't like that one. Ben's an idiot or whatever, but it'll help you hone in on the way you want to do it. There's some basic stuff that you'll want to follow, but then there's other stuff that's just personal preference. I hope that helps you. I love you. I hope you have a great evening.